हमारे वक्त की धड़कन, हमारा चिंतन, हमारी भावनाएं, हमारे विचार, कभी कोमल बातचीत तो कभी इंटरेक्शन तेज तर्रार। तय करें मिलकर व्हाट इज रॉन्ग व्हाट इज राइट। आईटीवी पर अशोक व्यास के साथ इनसाइट टुनाइट। नमस्कार, इनसाइट टुनाइट विद अशोक व्यास कार्यक्रम में आपका स्वागत है। टुडे इज मंडे एंड मंडे इज द डे व्हेन वी डेफिनेटली टॉक अबाउट इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स एंड भारतीय चुनाव जिस दौर में पहुंच गए हैं, एक्साइटमेंट बढ़ता जा रहा है और रोज रोज कुछ नई नई वक्तव्य, कुछ नई नई बातें, कुछ नए नए विचार। क्या इस बात का असर भारतीय जनता पार्टी के चुनावों में उनको मिलने वाले वोट्स पर पड़ सकता है? क्या राहुल गांधी के इस वक्तव्य से कांग्रेस को कुछ नुकसान हो सकता है? क्या होगा आने वाले समय में, इसका तय करने के लिए जब मतदाता अपने अपने मतदान स्थल तक पहुंच रहे हैं, तो कौन सी ऐसी बात है जो उनके मन को अब तक बदल सकती है? पार्टीज आर स्टिल वर्किंग वेरी हार्ड, लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ चुनावी रैलीज, कीपिंग नॉट ओनली एंगेज्ड बट आल्सो एंटरटेन्ड। एंड टुडे इट इज माय प्रिविलेज टू वेलकम members of our community based here but having their heart sometimes more tilted towards this or that party. So let me start by welcoming a young man who has found his heart resonating with the message of Aam Aadmi Party, and Rohan Chawla is with me today. Rohan ji, swagat hai aapka.
Namaskar.
And then right near him I have Vibhuti Jha ji, who is very well known to the community, and I remember long, long ago him presenting news for people here through one of the Indian stations. He has served the community in various capacity, but right now his heart is resonating with the message of Modi. So he's supporting Bharatiya Janata Party. And then someone who is not new to us as an attorney is known Anand Ahuja ji. Anand ji is with me, and with him is Dr. Parveen Chopra. Various decorated, well decorated, and is a professor, taught many important subjects, and his command over what is happening in India is always enlightening for us. So today, as we want to begin on the theme Indian election, the best choice. तो best choice हमारे लिए इस वक्त क्या है, इसके बारे में सबसे पहले मैं चाहता हूँ कि Rohan, share your thoughts. What is the best choice?
First of all, thank you very much for giving the opportunity to speak and give me my views on it. तो जैसे कि आपने कहा कि best choice, देखिए मेरे लिए तो best choice है अरविंद केजरीवाल जी। With due respect to all my seniors, सभी मेरे से एक्सपीरियंस में बहुत बड़े हैं और सभी की अपनी अपनी थॉट प्रोसेस है। मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा कि आज की डेट में आप किसी भी पार्टी को उठा लीजिए, चाहे वो बीजेपी हो, कांग्रेस हो, समाजवादी पार्टी हो, हर कोई ये कहता है, बीजेपी कहती है कि हमें कांग्रेस मुक्त भारत चाहिए, समाजवादी पार्टी कहती है कि हमें सेकुलर मुक्त, हमें बीजेपी मुक्त भारत चाहिए, कांग्रेस कहती है कि हमें बीजेपी मुक्त भारत चाहिए। आज की डेट में सिर्फ एक आम आदमी पार्टी एक ऐसी है जो कहती है हमें करप्शन मुक्त भारत चाहिए। वो किसी पार्टी मुक्त भारत नहीं चाहते, वो करप्शन मुक्त भारत चाहते हैं। दूसरा सबसे बड़ा कारण जो कि मैं अरविंद केजरीवाल और उनकी पार्टी को सपोर्ट करता हूँ, वो ये है कि हम लोग बिलीव करते हैं इन दी डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन ऑफ पावर। ये तो गांधी जी ने कहा था कि अगर हमको भारत को डेवलप करना है तो सबसे पहले हमें उसके गांव को डेवलप करना पड़ेगा, हमें ग्राम सभाओं को डेवलप करना पड़ेगा। ये जो डेवलपमेंट आज हम देख रहे हैं अर्बन डेवलपमेंट के नाम पर, गुड गवर्नेंस के नाम पर, इसने भारत को खोखला बना दिया है। तो मेरे लिए अगर आप मेरा वोट मानेंगे तो अरविंद केजरीवाल फॉर श्योर।
तो रोहन ये मानते हैं कि बेस्ट चॉइस जो है वो अरविंद केजरीवाल है, और उनके समर्थन में जो बिंदु उन्होंने दिए उसकी उसकी चीरफाड़ शब्द ठीक होगा क्या, उसके बारे में बातचीत हम बाद में करेंगे, क्योंकि खासकर जब वो ये कह रहे हैं कि कांग्रेस कह रही है भारतीय जनता पार्टी मुक्त और भारतीय जनता पार्टी कांग्रेस मुक्त, और वो कह रहे हैं करप्शन मुक्त, पर उन्होंने जब अपने उम्मीदवारों की फहरिस्त जाहिर की थी तब भी उन्होंने शुरुआती निगेटिविटी से की थी कि ये नहीं होंगे, इनको हराना, इनको हराना। बहरहाल उस पर चर्चा का समय बाद में आने वाला है, क्योंकि फिलहाल मैं निवेदन कर रहा हूँ विभूति झा जी से, व्हाट इज द बेस्ट चॉइस?
As you know, I'm supporting, my heart is with BJP this time for the simple reason that what exactly is the country looking for? What has happened in the last 10 years? Who is the person who can lead the country forward. And we have a man in Narendra Modi ji who has demonstrated with his leadership in the state of Gujarat that economic development can happen despite all the constraints that exist. You have to create opportunity, you have to create entrepreneurship, you have to do everything. And as my friend Rahul pointed out, corruption free. So Narendra Modi ji has led a corruption to the background and developed the state in the way that it ought to be. Now that's a proven material. Now the question here will be, again, my question to request to all of you is, those who are sitting on the fence wondering who to vote for, is recognize that in democracy you get the government you deserve. The question that you have to ask, if you're looking for growth, if you're looking for economic improvement, you're looking for jobs, you are looking for a corruption-free system, Narendra Modi has proven it. There is no other person who has done that. He has not only talked about it, he has shown it, that it can happen. And just one, I'm from Bihar. The state suffers from lack of entrepreneurship and lack of economic growth. An attack was made on Mr. Modi that Gujarat model will not work in Bihar. And I said only one thing, that if somehow Biharis are able to import the entrepreneurship of Gujarat, I think that will make a phenomenal difference to the country and the state as well. So let's get going with that thought process, and let's elect Mr. Modi and give him a chance to run not only the state, but the country as well.
So let us give a chance to Mr. Modi, are the words of Vibhuti Jha ji. But what are the challenges that are there for him to reach the coveted position or responsibility of being Prime Minister of the great nation, India? We will talk about that. But right now, I think I have the pleasure of welcoming two individuals who are looking at the election objectively. And Anand Ahuja ji earlier was known to have his heart resonating more with the message of Congress. But now, I think he has found a kind of transition or transformation in his heart, or maybe he was not understood correctly when he shared his views, which look like are coming from his position of being a congressman. So Anandji, let me request you, as an Indian at this moment, what do you consider to be the best choice for the nation?
Ashok ji, once again, it's an honor and privilege to be on your show. And as you said very rightly, and I will also like to make a disclaimer that my views expressed here are my personal views. I'm not a representative of any political party. I have never associated myself with any political party in my life, whether it's a Democrats or Republicans, Congress, BJP. Yes, my thinking, if you ask me, I'm a man of secular thinking. Secular philosophy is my philosophy. So any party that believes in secularism, and India's constitution, if you see, foundation, if you see, is based on secularism. So that extent, whether it's a Congress, BJP, Aam Aadmi, whichever party emphasizes on secularism, that is my party. Now coming back to which political candidate will be better as a Prime Minister of India, first of all, we have to keep in mind that it's not BJP that we are talking is going to form, get absolute majority, and BJP is going to form the government. It's NDA. NDA consists of various groups. Most of them, they are from the regional parties. Taking that thing into consideration, I have my personal doubts that even if, let's say, for argument's sake, NDA gets majority of seats, Modi will be Prime Minister. I personally believe.
Just a 30-second interruption. So, not just your doubts, but in the given circumstances, what do you think is the best choice?
In the given circumstances, if NDA comes into power, then I personally believe that Arun Jaitley will be the best candidate for the Prime Ministership, or Sushma Swaraj, one of them. But chances are that, again, considering the politics going on within the BJP party nowadays, to me it appears that most likely Arun Jaitri will be, and he should be. First of all, he's from hardcore BJP party, but at the same time, if you see that he's a man with a secular outlook, he falls into both categories. I will say on the borderline of liberals as well as.
I appreciate your comments, Anandji, and the way you're using the word secularism and the way it is being used consistently by Congress. So there is some resonance there, and probably it is not as close as you would like it to be, so that you would say, yes, I represent Congress. So that is understandable. And now, moving towards Dr. Chopra, you heard all three of them. In your views, whose argument, if we compare with the Aam Aadmi Party and Bharatiya Janata Party, of course, Congress stands out in your mind, given the way India is at the moment?
First of all, let's see this from the point of view of India. If we have to select the best candidate, we have to look at it, which kind of a candidate is needed by India today. First of all, the rate of inflation, which used to be over 10%, which is now being tamed at this point, has wrecked the economy. Number two, the rate of growth of India was over 10%. 10.5, sometime 11 also, we retouched that point, and it has come down to 4.5%. So obviously, economy is the most important factor right now. Number three, corrupt government. There's no doubt about it. 3 years ago, when I was in India, every day I will open up the newspaper, every day there were scandals. This year, when I was in India only last week ago, and I came back, and I saw at least the Congress party has tamed that part down. We don't see that kind of scandals taking place at an enormous level. But their party is tainted. They had a very good chance for almost 10 years, and they haven't brought the change. Another angle to look at is foreign direct investment in India has trickled down. At one point of time, India had a surplus of $360 billion, which was really fueling the economy. Why is it the rest of the countries are not pouring any money into India? There's no doubt about it. We need a leader who can revive the economy, who can unify the country, who has a track record, and there's no doubt about it. Mr. Modi stands out in terms of qualification, in terms of experience, and in terms of his ability to galvanize the parties. And I think he deserves a chance, but at the same time, he has a tainted record. That was almost about 12, 13 years ago, that Godhra Khand, but he has never been at least implicated. He has never been kind of held any guilty in any of the judicial inquiries, so that goes to his advantage. He has stood the scrutiny of every possible machinery in India, in the state, in the center, and there's no doubt about it. At this point, he seems to be the best candidate for the country.
So, looks like Narendra Modi seems to be the best candidate for the country, is what we hear not only from people when we talk to them, but also many newspapers in India are coming up with their survey findings, which looks at Narendra Modi as a potential prime minister. But if you read the foreign media, be it The Economist or maybe article in the New York Times also, and other newspapers, everybody has their concerns, apprehensions, and of course Congress would like this kind of momentum to continue. And there are many intellectuals in India who, even in Bollywood for the first time, came out openly calling for secularism to be the guiding force for deciding who should lead the nation. Now, how far BJP manages to overcome all the apprehensions and arguments which are putting question mark on his ability to lead a unified India, we will talk about them, and Vibhuti Jaji will have a lot of explanations for us, probably with reference to Article 370's reference coming back, or statements of leaders like Giriraj Singh and Praveen Togadia. So there is much more waiting for us right after this short break.
To advertise in this show, please call 347-653-1309.
Santoshi Mata Astrology Center presents Pandit Ram Prasad. He can accurately predict your past, present, and future. He specializes in bringing your loved ones back and getting rid of black magic, obeah, and evil spirits. Consult for problems related to love, marriage, job, business, marital issues, or sexual problems. Call now on 347-220-5384 or visit 13111 Liberty Avenue, Richmond Hills.
Spirituality is the medium which frees our mind of all emotional shackles and temptations and guides us towards enlightenment and peace. Himali Spiritual Center is the gateway to liberation from pain, misery, and suffering. Here, through religion, meditation, yoga, worship, and gem therapy, all troubles are treated. Himali Spiritual Center, 718-887-2929.
Your eyes are the windows to your world. Trust your eyes to Malik Eye Care. This is where ophthalmology, optometry, and opticianry join under one roof to meet all your vision needs. Our offices house a plethora of state-of-the-art lasers and diagnostic equipment. I'm a board-certified ophthalmologist and a member of the American Academy of Ophthalmology, and also a fellow of the American College of Physicians and Surgeons. I've done thousands of ocular surgeries to restore vision to many patients. Consult our offices to see how we can improve your vision. We look forward to seeing you at your next appointment.
क्या बात है मास्टर फिरोज, यूएसए से बहुत प्यार हो गया है आपको?
ऑफ कोर्स, वहां पे पता नहीं आपको कितना सारा टैलेंट है.
सो लेट्स डू दिस गाइस, DID लिटिल मास्टर्स ऑडिशंस ऑल अक्रॉस नॉर्थ अमेरिका.
गेट रेडी नॉर्थ अमेरिका,
अमेरिका एंड कनाडा,
ड्रीम्स आर अबाउट टू कम ट्रू, सो डांस इट आउट.
DID Little Masters USA Audition. Log on to zdilse.com to submit your video or to record your audition. For local audition information, log on to aryaintl.com.
वेलकम बैक, यू वाचिंग इनसाइड नेट विद द शो. हम बात कर रहे हैं बेस्ट चॉइस भारत के लिए क्या है. भारत के मतदाता जब अपने मतदान का प्रयोग करने जा रहे हैं तो ये सवाल उनके साथ साथ चलता है कि मेरे इस वोट से जो निर्णय होने वाला है उससे मेरे देश का क्या होगा, एंड व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट हेल्प्स देम डिसाइड दिस. आई थिंक समवेयर हाउ लीडर्स आर कनेक्टिंग विद देम प्रॉब्ली ऑल्सो प्लेज एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. ऑफकोर्स वॉट दे क्लेम becomes clear down the line, but just talking about the personality factor, if we look at Arvind Kejriwal, Rahul Gandhi, and Narendra Modi. So I would start off this time with you, Parveen Chopraji. You have heard these candidates connect with the masses through their speeches. Very briefly, who do you think scores more in terms of his ability to connect with people?
I think Mr. Modi is a wonderful orator. There's no doubt about it. He is the kind of a person who is, all the polls are telling, his popularity has been on the rise from last year till this year. Look at the number of votes that were being projected for BJP in July of 2013. They were saying they will never get more than 170 votes, 170 members of parliament. And Congress was given about 157. And look at where the predictions are today. They are telling anything between 210 to 232. Those are the number of MPs who will be joining BJP, and they will be winners. Now, if you look at Aam Aadmi Party, I think Aam Aadmi Party, some or the other, is the big question mark for BJP, because the votes that go to Aam Aadmi Party are the ones that would have gone to BJP. And obviously, the difference today between 190 to 230 232, the 42 votes is the Aam Aadmi Party, which according to me is going to get anything from 20 to 40 maximum. Previously, I used to think no more than 5% of the votes.
So we'll come back to this. Just staying with the ability to connect with the masses, which leader? Anandji, what would be your pick?
If you ask me, I'll be very frank and open with you. I personally believe that Arvind Kejriwal stands out in that particular respect. If you compare Aam Aadmi Party with BJP or Congress, or for that matter, any regional party, Aam Aadmi Party is in infancy. It's just newly formed party. And the way this party has come up in a very short period of time, I personally believe that credit goes to Mr. Arvind Kejriwal. Mr. Modi, Rahul Gandhi, and all others, they have been in politics for the last, I do not know for how many centuries. How many decades? Considering that particular factor, I believe Arvind Kejriwal stands out. And even if, let's say, in this particular election, Aam Aadmi Party does not get too many seats in parliament, but I think they have made a mark there.
Okay, so you talk about making a mark, and I'll have Roshan respond to this first. Talking about connecting with the masses, and recently we have seen instances where Arvind Kejriwal had to experience some unpleasant happenings on the street during his road shows. So that puts a kind of question mark in terms of his ability to hold his ground and connect with people. And after all these protests against him, he also admitted recently that probably resigning from chief ministership of Delhi was a quick and hasty decision. Probably they made a mistake there. So now, in the light of this, listening to what Anandji says about his ability to connect with the masses, what do you feel? And if you just be objective, the way you are looking at various election meetings, who seems to have more tool in his expression to...
तो देखिए यहाँ पर आपके तीन क्वेश्चन हैं. पहला क्वेश्चन है कि एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल, किसकी ज़्यादा एबिलिटी है लोगों से कनेक्ट करने में. दूसरा क्वेश्चन है कि जो अरविंद केजरीवाल जी का आपने बताया कि उनको कुछ अनप्लेजेंट हैपनिंग्स झेलनी पड़ी, और तीसरा क्वेश्चन ये कि आपने जैसे बताया कि उन लोगों ने उन्होंने माना कि शायद उन्होंने गलती कर दी चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप छोड़ के, तो मैं एक करके सबका जवाब देता हूँ. देखिए सबसे पहले एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल, जैसे कि रिस्पेक्टेड प्रवीण सर ने भी कहा कि भाई मोदी जी को ही इज़ अ वेरी गुड ऑरेटर, बट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल अ वेरी स्मॉल पॉइंट दैट गुड ऑरेटरी कैन मिसगाइड पीपल. इवन हिटलर वॉज अ वेरी गुड ऑरेटर. नाउ डोंट से यू नो आई एम कंपेयरिंग मोदी विद हिटलर, बट आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू स्टेटिस्टिकली दैट इवन हिटलर वॉज वेरी गुड ऑरेटर. ऑरेटरी कैन मिसगाइड पीपल. नाउ अगर लोगों से कनेक्ट करने की क्षमता, आप उसको कहेंगे कि कोई इंसान एक हेलीकॉप्टर में आता है और जहाँ पर वो लाखों की तादाद में भीड़ जो ट्रेन्स में बुलाई गई होती है, जिनको पैसे दिए गए होते हैं, जिनको खाने का पैसा दिया जाता है, उनको बुला के उनको एड्रेस करता है और एक यू नो अच्छी खासी स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ के वो स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ता है और वहाँ से निकल जाता है हेलीकॉप्टर में वापस, अगर आप उसको कहते हैं एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल, तो यस इट इज़ एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल. बट लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है.
एक्चुअली मैं आपको इंटरव्यू इसलिए कर रहा हूँ क्योंकि मैं उसको नहीं कह रहा हूँ एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल. आप जब उसको बोलते हुए सुन रहे हैं तो लोगों का रिस्पांस कैसा है, वो किस तरह की भाषा में बात कर रहा है, किस तरह से आर्टिकुलेट कर रहा है अपनी बात को, वो सब उस स्किल में.
उसी के लिए मैंने बोला कि अ गुड ऑरेटरी कैन ऑलवेज मिसगाइड पीपल. नाउ वी हैव टू लुक एट इट फ्रॉम द टू पर्सपेक्टिव. तो अरविंद केजरीवाल जी, जैसा कि सर ने भी बोला और इस बात को मिस्टर सॉरी आपका नाम मिस्टर आनंद जी ने भी माना कि भाई हम लोगों ने पिछले एक साल में, अभी मैं शायद कल परसों एक इंटरव्यू पढ़ रहा था, किसी ने आर्टिकल लिखा था, उसमें लिखा था कि अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने पिछले एक साल में 100 से ज़्यादा प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करी हैं. हमारे जो मिस्टर मोदी जी हैं उन्होंने पिछले 10 साल में शायद कुछ मुझे 20-30 प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेस करी होंगी.
स्टैटिस्टिक्स में जाना हमारे लिए जरूरी
है. एग्जैक्टली.
पर रोशन आपकी बात, रोहन आपकी बात मैं मान लेता हूँ. आपकी दृष्टि में अरविंद केजरीवाल
हाँ जी बेहतर है. तो मैं एक सवाल का और जवाब दे दूं आपका. सॉरी आपने बोला एक मिनट सॉरी आपने एक सवाल और बोला कि अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने ये एडमिट किया कि उन्होंने गलती करी
जी
चीफ मिनिस्टर, लेकिन अगर आपने उसको, उन्होंने ये बोला था इंटरव्यू में कि सिद्धांतों पे हमने राजनीति छोड़ी, वो गलत नहीं था शायद. हाँ हमको जनता से कनेक्ट करना चाहिए था, लेकिन उन्होंने ये कभी नहीं कहा कि उन्होंने चीफ मिनिस्टर की कुर्सी छोड़े गलती कर दी. उन्होंने बोला कि वो छोड़ना सही था, हम कठपुतली बनके नहीं बैठे से बैठ रहे.
मैं एक सेकंड,
मैं चाहता हूं कि हमारे एक दर्शक की बात सुने फिर विभूति झा जी की तरफ बढ़े. हेलो आईटीवी लाइव.
हां जी
जी फरमाएं.
नमस्कार जी.
नमस्कार सर.
मैं जगत शर्मा बोल रहा हूं.
हां जी फरमाएं.
मेरा कहने का मतलब यह है कि जैसे कि केसर राज जी सर कह रहे हैं
जी,
आप इनको कहो और उनको जो राजनीतिक लोग होते हैं उन्होंने 15-20 साल राजनीति में बिताए हैं
जी,
तब उनको कुछ एक्सपीरियंस हुआ है, तो केजरीलाल को चाहिए 5-10 साल पॉलिटिक्स में जाए, वो पॉलिटिक्स ठीक है, उनको पॉलिटिक्स नहीं आती तो वो नारेबाजी करते हैं
जी।
नारेबाजी करना और पॉलिटिक्स करना ये बड़ा दोनों चीजें अलग है।
तो आपकी बात इन तक पहुंच गई है, धन्यवाद, आप हमारे साथ बने रहे और हमारी बातचीत में आगे भी आपका साथ लेंगे।
मतलब जी
जी, जी।
उन्होंने बहुत साल राजनीति में बिताए हैं।
तो मैं जगत जी आपका धन्यवाद करते हुए, और अनुभव की आवश्यकता है नहीं, आनंद जी पहले विभूति जी से मैं जानना चाहूंगा कि जो स्किल्स की बात होती है जिससे कि ऐसा लगता है कि जनता को ये महसूस होता है कि ये वक्ता मेरे मन की बात समझता है, उस पैमाने पर अरविंद केजरीवाल, नरेंद्र मोदी, राहुल गांधी कंपेयर करें।
इट इज अ वेरी इजी कंपैरिजन एंड आई थैंक डॉक्टर चोपड़ा फॉर आर्टिकुलेटिंग व्हाई ही बिलीव्स दैट मिस्टर मोदी इज द राइट कैंडिडेट। नाउ हियर वाज व्हाट वी सॉ फ्रॉम आम आदमी एंड हियर वाज आम आदमी ऑन द टेलीफोन। व्हाट हैपेंड इन दिल्ली, आम आदमी पार्टी गॉट द चांस टू रन द कंट्री। व्हाट डिड दे डू? द इनएक्सपीरियंस विच दिस आम आदमी पॉइंटेड आउट हियर was the exact thing that happened. They ran away. I call them the runaway bride. Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, the perfect example of a runaway bride, or Hindi mein usko kahenge bhagoda. Responsibility dekhi aur bhage. The question is, you can't apologize. The leadership role comes in facing the situation as it is. You can't consult. Leadership is not a function of hindsight. Ki, I wish I would have done that. In cricket, if you are run out, you can't say, I should have consulted with my batsman on the other end. Now you have to wait for the next innings to play. So Mr. Kejriwal, people of India, people of Delhi, gave you a great opportunity to prove your worth in Delhi, and you run away. Sorry, you can't do that with the fate of the country. Second point, and that's very important. Why does Mr. Modi connect with people? Because of the fact that he's authentic in what he says, he means what he says, and he has done what he says he will do for the country. And Gujarat is the example. He's not lying about that. It's for everybody to see what it is. It is that integrity and truthfulness that has enabled them to connect with the people directly. And which is what Aam Aadmi, Arvind Kejriwal, had a beautiful topic of corruption. Every single Indian is fed up of corruption. But that was also Anna Hazare who led the initial challenge on that. So Mr. Kejriwal has carried that forward. Good for you. But beyond that, what? And that's the issue which people are talking about today.
So people are talking about many, many things, and a few things we are also going to be talking about in today's shows. And Anandji has a comment, but before that, because he's a defense attorney, so I give him something for which Rohan will also share his defense. The thing is, we have heard a lot of people have complained Aam Aadmi Party for inconsistency in their approach. The second thing is, people feel that because it's a newborn party and they were initially focusing on Delhi and then now they are all over the nation, so they have diluted their resources and probably this is also hurting them in creating a powerful campaign.
देखिए, हम लोगों को ये समझना पड़ेगा कि जिस तरीके से इस देश की राजनीति आज तक चलती आई हुई है कि एक इंडिविजुअल सेंट्रिक राजनीति रही है हमारे देश की हमेशा, कभी इंदिरा गांधी, फिर कभी हमारे सबसे पहले नेहरू जी के उसमें, फिर इंदिरा गांधी, फिर राजीव गांधी, अब राहुल गांधी, नरेंद्र मोदी, इस तरीके से एक हमारी आइडेंटिटी बेस्ड पॉलिटिक्स रही है हमेशा। केजरीवाल जी ने बहुत बार कहा है और हम लोग सभी उसको मानते हैं कि अकेले केजरीवाल जी इस देश को नहीं बदल सकते। जैसे कि मिस्टर जगत ने कहा कि भाई इनएक्सपीरियंस्ड है और दे जस्ट रैन अवे, सर ने भी बोला, मैं इसको बिल्कुल नहीं मानता। अगर इस देश को बदलना है तो टीम ऑफ एक्सपर्ट लगानी पड़ेगी। हमारे पास, आम आदमी पार्टी के पास टीम ऑफ एक्सपर्ट है, मिस्टर योगेंद्र यादव, मेधा पाटकर जो कि पता नहीं कितने सालों से इन रेवोल्यूशंस में लगी हुई हैं, डॉक्टर राजमोहन गांधी, आदर्श शास्त्री, मिस्टर बालकृष्णन एंड सो मेनी नेम दैट आई कैनॉट इवन थिंक ऑफ इट राइट नाउ. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि कोई भी इंसान, चाहे वो मिस्टर मोदी हो, चाहे वो राहुल गांधी हो, चाहे वो अरविंद केजरीवाल हो, चाहे वो आप या मैं हूँ, एक अकेला इंसान, एक कहावत होती है ना कि अकेला चना भाड़ भी नहीं फोड़ सकता, माइंड माई हिंदी, मतलब इतना अगर मैंने कुछ गलत बोला हो तो कोई अकेला इंसान कभी भी किसी भी देश को नहीं बदल सकता. आम आदमी पार्टी ने वो मौका दिया लोगों को कि मुझ जैसा यूथ जो कि यहाँ बैठा है, अच्छी खासी सैलरी कमा रहा है, उसको क्या पड़ी है देश के बारे में सोचने की. लेकिन वो यूथ जो कि देश को आगे बढ़ाएगा, जो कि 21वीं सदी में भारत का नाम रोशन करेगा, वो इन्वॉल्व हो रहा है अकॉर्डिंग इन अलॉन्ग विद द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ पीपल लाइक योगेंद्र यादव, बालकृष्णन एंड ऑल अदर पीपल दैट आई कैन नॉट थिंक ऑफ राइट.
तो आपके ख्याल से डाइल्यूट नहीं हुए
बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम इंडिया टूडे फेसिंग इज that there are too many politicians, seasoned politicians there. If we get rid of all those seasoned politicians and we have some honest people to run this country, then probably this country can be saved. So if you ask me my opinion, I will say rather after 10 years, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal should quit in politics, because by that time he'll be, maybe most likely he'll also be like other politicians in India. But right now we need somebody who is not a seasoned politician. Okay, secondly, coming back to that question, Mr. Vibhuti Jha said that Bhagoda, he ran away. We are missing one point here, that when Mr. Arvind Kejriwal formed government in Delhi, Mr. Kejriwal's party did not have absolute majority. It was a limping on the shoulders of Congress party. If Mr. Kejriwal could have continued with the same Congress party for a little longer period of time, then people like Mr. Vibhuti Jha, who are representative of BJP, would have criticized Mr. Kejriwal that, look here is a man who was shouting, criticizing all the time against the Congress government, that they are creating so much corruption in this country, and now Mr. Kejriwal is dependent upon Congress party. I personally believe Mr. Kejriwal did a very right, very shrewd decision by quitting and letting the whole world know that, look here, I am not after party.
Because I want Dr. Chopra also to respond, and I want to add to what you just said. What you are saying is, if you face opposition, then you quit and you don't try to work together with people.
If you have absolute majority,
that you you have to find solutions, and in order to find solutions, you will never have everything given in the perfect manner to you.
No, but at stake was that bill.
Sir, इसमें मैं एक पॉइंट ऐड करना चाहूँगा. मुझे बस दो सेकंड दीजिए.
We'll come back to you. What do you think about this?
First of all, the demand made by Mr. Kejriwal that he should get the entire control of Delhi administration in his hand was a totally unreasonable demand. India has a responsibility to project the best image with regard to the rest of the world. He should have been satisfied with the control of Delhi local police, and that's what he had.
No, he didn't have.
Okay.
Home Minister, that he, as far as the local police is concerned, the police chief reports to him.
I'm sorry to say that, but your information is not correct. Your information is not correct. That was the reason he sat on Dharna.
He should have, if he didn't have the complete control of the local issues, then he should have fought for that purpose only. Not that, you know, central government gives the entire control. Let me proceed ahead also on this issue.
Actually, बहुत सारा पानी बह चुका है और अब हम जहाँ पर आ गए हैं वो दिल्ली बहुत पीछे छूट गई है. अब पूरे
इसमें दो सेकंड दीजिए, मैं एक पॉइंट ऐड करना चाहता हूँ.
बिल्कुल. There is a point to be made here.
Both of you.
And the point to be made here is, and you are very right about that. People you fought for winning the state of Delhi is a capital of the country. You are the chief minister of that place. And you very rightly pointed out, if you wanted to do something, you didn't have to hide behind, I can't do this, give me that, all the power, then only I will do this. You had a brilliant opportunity to create an opportunity to do something and demonstrate.
Come on, it's a minority government, it's a minority government.
Point that he was having a Congress support. Congress party gave the support. So I suspect there was some milibhagat there and something went wrong.
Okay, very briefly.
Okay, तो देखिए हम लोग अभी शायद इसी बात पे फोकस हो गए हैं कि दिल्ली से उन्होंने क्यों छोड़ दिया चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप. तो देखिए हम थोड़ा पीछे जाते हैं इसमें. जब वो गवर्नमेंट बनाने वाले थे, हम लोगों ने एक चिट्ठी लिखी थी जो हमने कांग्रेस को भी दी थी, बीजेपी को भी दी थी. बीजेपी ने तो खैर रिस्पॉन्स ही नहीं किया, तो छोड़िए. जहाँ तक कांग्रेस की बात है, उन्होंने बोला था 18 पॉइंट जो हमारे थे सब पे वो सपोर्ट करेंगे, जिसमें जन लोकपाल बिल एक मुद्दा था. तो अब ये बताइए मुझे कि कौन हटा इससे पीछे, कांग्रेस हटी या आम आदमी पार्टी हटी? नंबर टू, देखिए हम लोग क्या, आपने कहा कि देखिए वो एक लीडर थे, उनको नेगोशिएट करना चाहिए था लोगों के साथ, दिस इज कॉल्ड यू नो, बट क्या नेगोशिएट करते? हम जन लोकपाल बिल लेकर आ रहे थे. अगर वो बिल आ जाता तो आधी बीजेपी आधी कांग्रेस जेल में चली जाती. तो किसके मतलब जिसके अगेंस्ट हम बिल लेकर आ रहे हैं उनके साथ कैसे नेगोशिएट करते हैं, ये हमको समझना पड़ेगा. दिस इज नॉट लाइक के
कोई और पार्टी होती है तो आया राम गया राम शुरू हो जाता है.
हम लोग
हमारे इधर आ जाइए,
हम लोग मिनिस्टरशिप लेते हैं. हम लोग कभी भी दलाली की राजनीति करना नहीं जानते. हमारी जो राजनीति रही है हमेशा से सिद्धांतों की, सच्चाई की और आम आदमी की राजनीति रही है.
ये जो हमेशा 2 साल से पहले शुरू हुआ है, उसके बहुत सारे नेता जो आम आदमी पार्टी में आए हैं वो पहले अन्य पार्टियों से भी आए हैं. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि वो एकदम सडनली.
लेकिन आपको ये चीज ध्यान रखनी होगी कि हमने हमेशा कहा है कि हर पार्टी में, देखिए आपको ये समझना होगा, आज की डेट में एक बीजेपी और कांग्रेस जो है वो एक माफिया के थ्रू कंट्रोल हो रही है. माइंड माय लैंग्वेज, एक माफिया के थ्रू कंट्रोल हो रही है. एक मिनट सर, सर प्लीज गिव मी दी, प्लीज प्लीज गिव मी,
आई
थिंक वी आर स्टक ऑन
इंपॉर्टेंट. यू कॉल बीजेपी माफिया, you call Narendra Modi like Hitler, but oh, he's not like Hitler, but I'm calling him Hitler.
Okay, let me just reiterate that. I agree with you on this.
Has Arvind Kejriwal ever demonstrated? He was in Income Tax Department, which is a den of corruption in India. Let's ask him one question. What did he do in Income Tax Department to streamline processes and remove corruption there?
But can an employee in any government office can do anything?
Listen, request. The thing is, things move in a fashion that is structured. And that structure now demands for this show that we should take this next break. And we will continue right after this break.
To advertise in this show, please call 347-653-1309.
Spirituality is the medium which frees our mind of all emotional shackles and temptations and guides us towards enlightenment and peace. Himali Spiritual Center is the gateway to liberation from pain, misery and suffering. Here, through religion, meditation, yoga, worship and gem therapy, all troubles are treated. Himali Spiritual Center, 718-887-2929.
When considering where to host your wedding banquet or party, consider the Lafayette Yard Hotel, conveniently located in central New Jersey. The Lafayette Yard Hotel offers a beautifully appointed grand ballroom with seating for up to 400 people and over 150 guest rooms, including 4 suites and ample, safe, enclosed parking in the adjacent garage. The Lafayette is truly your best choice. Call Ibrahim at 404-491-5674 or 609-421-4000 and make an appointment today.
I am your immigration attorney, Michael Fulwani.
And I'm your immigration attorney, David Nachman.
Keep watching us, our program on immigration and you.
For the latest information, updates, and developments about immigration law.
Every Saturday at 8:15 p.m.
And wake up to us on Sunday at 11:45 a.m.
Consult Swami Manjiji for accurate horoscope reading, palm reading, and likelihood of love, marriage, children, business, health, immigration, and court cases. Swamiji removes black magic, gives protection, and helps in removing various problems by powerful holy mantras and meditation on God. Free check of black magic. Excellent results. Call 718-358-2901. The number again, 718-358-2901.
वेलकम बैक, यू वाचिंग इनसाइड टुनाइट विद अशोक व्यास. हम बात कर रहे हैं बेस्ट चॉइस भारत के लिए क्या है, और बेस्ट चॉइस की बात करते हुए जब हम पीछे मुड़ते हैं तो कुछ बातों की बहस फिर छिड़ जाती है जो हमें आगे ले जाने से रोकती है. बहुत सारी बातें हैं जो हमें आगे ले जाने से रोक रही हैं, और उनमें जो मुद्दे नए नए उछल रहे हैं जो नरेंद्र मोदी की प्रधानमंत्री पद तक की यात्रा में रुकावट बन सकते हैं, उसमें से क्या ये संदर्भ जिसे हम वहाँ धारा 370 कहते हैं, जिसका उल्लेख भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अध्यक्ष राजनाथ सिंह जी ने न केवल किया बल्कि उन्होंने ये भी कहा कि धारा 370 के द्वारा जम्मू कश्मीर को लाभ हुआ हो ऐसा लगता तो नहीं है, इस पर बहस होनी चाहिए. और इस मुद्दे को लेकर बहुत लोग पहले ही अपना विरोध और रोष प्रकट कर चुके हैं. जब भारतीय जनता पार्टी के मैनिफेस्टो में 370 का उल्लेख हुआ था उसको लेकर काफी नाराजगी पहले भी व्यक्त की जाती रही है. तो इससे पहले कि विभूति जी इस बारे में क्या सोचते हैं, मैं चाहता हूं प्रवीण जी क्या सोचते हैं. इज इट नेसेसरी टू ब्रिंग दिस एंड से दैट इट हैज नॉट रियली सर्व्ड द पर्पस ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर?
सर्टेनली इट हैज सर्व्ड द पर्पस. एट दैट टाइम इट वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द सिचुएशन वॉज वेरी टेंस. देयर वॉज आर्मी ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द बॉर्डर एंड दैट वॉज द बेस्ट सोल्यूशन दैट वॉज टेकन एट दैट टाइम. एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज प्रोवाइडेड प्रोटेक्शन नॉट ओनली टू जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एरिया बट ऑल द एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड. People from urban areas, they don't go over there and start buying the land. There are other, like Himachal Pradesh. If you are not born in Himachal Pradesh, you are not allowed to buy the land either.
I just want you to focus on how this might reflect on the number of votes which would reach towards BJP.
It is certainly a volatile issue. And many of these deep-seated issues are going to come up based upon who wins the election. What is their agenda? If you get Mr. Modi coming into that, there's no doubt about it. He's not going to get any Muslim votes. That's very clear. First of
Why
all,
should that be so clear?
Because the Shah of Imam, he has already made an appeal to the Muslim community.
No, right
that
here,
they should.
I had a Muslim leader from Congress saying that his call is not acceptable to all Muslims.
Well, that is the opposition to that, but religion and politics cannot be mixed. If it was to happen here, they would have taken away the status of not-for-profit organization right away. They cannot be mixed. No matter where you go in the world, religion and politics are always kept separate.
Before we go to Vibhuti ji, Anand ji, in your opinion personally, do you think there is a need to revisit Article 370?
I personally believe, yes, it is a time, as Dr. Praveen Chopra mentioned, that there was a time and you have to take into consideration the circumstances of that particular time. Now, at this particular stage, I personally believe that in India, why a particular state should be given a preferential treatment over the other state? And based upon that, I personally believe that it won't have any adverse effect upon BJP.
Sounds good. Let me take a call and we continue. Hello, ITV Live.
Yes, can I talk to Asad ji, please?
जी, मैं बोल रहा हूँ, आप टीवी का वॉल्यूम कम करें, बात करें.
हाँ जी.
जी.
Asad ji, नमस्ते.
नमस्ते, नमस्ते.
अच्छा, हमेशा मैं सुन रहा हूँ ये करप्शन. इनको पूछो करप्शन कैसे बना?
इसकी जिसकी चर्चा पे हम जाएंगे, अभी हम आर्टिकल 370 की बात कर लेते हैं.
अच्छा, जी जी. मुझे लगता है मैंने ये कभी पॉलिटिकल में नहीं आ रहा हूँ, लेकिन मैं तो ऑटो टेक्निशियन हूँ.
अच्छा.
जब मैंने जरा स्किन देखा ना, मुझे मालूम पड़ा ये करप्शन मुझे कांग्रेस के लिए हो गया, क्योंकि कांग्रेस सिर्फ यूनिवर्स टाइप में से काम किया, राइटिंग में किया नहीं, 66 ईयर्स.
जी.
सो उसके द्वारा उसने कंट्रोल नहीं किया. क्यों? हिंदुस्तान में इतना प्रॉब्लम था और हिंदुस्तान इतना टॉर्चर किया, वर्ल्ड में कोई कंट्री नहीं कर सकते.
जी.
आज मैं 15 साल पहले मुझे जरा स्किन मालूम पड़ा, और 15 साल पहले मैंने जब इंडिया प्रेस में गया था, मुझे रोना आया.
आपका फोन करने के लिए धन्यवाद है। हम आपकी बात को भी अपने पैनलिस्ट के साथ
जारी रखेंगे। मोदी जी को आने दो, अब ये सब कुछ छोड़ दो, नेक्स्ट 10 इयर्स में।
थैंक यू सर। सो उनका कहना है कि मोदी जी को आने दो। मोदी जी के आने में जो बात रुकावट हो सकती है वो क्या ये हो सकता है, संदर्भ जो राजनाथ सिंह जी ने लिया 370?
आई थिंक आनंद जी आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन वेरी वेल, दैट यू नो देयर कम्स अ मोमेंट इन टाइम इन योर लाइफ व्हेन यू नीड टू इवैल्यूएट वेयर वी स्टैंड विद रेफरेंस टू इश्यूज ए बी सी डी ई एफ। आर्टिकल 370 इज वन सच इशू। It is a legacy of Mr. Nehru's. Like, it is Mr. Nehru's legacy that he referred the matter to gain that accession instrument. He conceded something for his own home state. Likewise, there are so many things that need to be revisited if we have to change the angle of growth, if we have to change the story, the narrative. For example, non-aligned movement needs to be looked at. Because from my point of view, non-aligned movement is an absolutely utopian, silly idea, which at one point in time looked great and lofty. But what is the layman's translation of non-aligned? Friends help friends. Friends help friends over the non-aligned. What happens is, in the process, you are friends of nobody. So the question is that if you have a policy, let's revisit it, relevant today or not. Likewise, reservation policy, let's revisit that. Let's visit. So unless and until we reflect and look at what is the new circumstances, we have to revisit. And I don't think it is going to affect, I don't think it is going to affect Mr. BJP, because at least he has dared to be different, to ask of questions that people are uncomfortable about. And that's the biggest sign of a challenge the leadership takes, that you have to be aware that what issues are uncomfortable, can we deal with them? Can we put it in the open for a discussion? And if the re-examination shows that Article 370 must continue, that's all right. But there is no harm in discussing a challenge which is hurting or impacting the minds of people adversely. Thank you, Anandji.
So now there are arguments in favor of the possibility of having a debate about Article 370, but these are the people sitting here in New York. If there is someone who hails from Jammu and Kashmir watching this show, do call us and share what do you think. And what we have heard from some people from Jammu and Kashmir who are very vocal, that includes leader of an important party there, they said there is no question of discussing or revisiting. They might have their reasons, but how do you think, Rohan, in India, people at large may respond to this reference?
देखिए, अगर आप मेरे से पर्सनली पूछेंगे, सो आई विल बी वेरी फ्रैंक विद यू दैट आई रियली डोंट हैव मच अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट आर्टिकल 370, बट स्टिल वट एवर लिटिल बिट अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई हैव अबाउट आर्टिकल 370, मेरे को आई थिंक द ओनली वे यू कैन विन पीपल ऑन योर साइड इज थ्रू टॉक्स। यू कैनॉट विन पीपल ऑन योर साइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ आर्म्स और आर्मी, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ आर्मी। सो अगेन, एज सर सेड, एंड आई थिंक इन अ डेमोक्रेसी चेंज इज द लॉ ऑफ नेचर। If the all the big political leaders think that we should revisit it and, you know, come with a better solution for the people of Jammu and Kashmir, we should go for that. We should not be stick to one idea that because it was good 40 years back, it still holds good today as well. That's my personal philosophy on this one.
Thank you very much. And let's take this call. Hello, ITV Live. Aapko meri awaaz aa rahi hai? I think we lost you, and we'll continue. There are other issues also which have surfaced just in last a day or two, which are very volatile in nature, and they come directly towards the doorstep of Narendra Modi, because these are the RSS leader or some Hindutva leaders making some claims. So there is one Giriraj Singh against whom FIR has also been lodged, and Parvinji, he said that जो लोग मोदी के विरोधी हैं उनको पाकिस्तान चले जाना चाहिए। एंड व्हेन ही वाज क्वेश्चन ऑन गिविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ स्टेटमेंट बाय राजनाथ सिंह, आई थिंक ही सेड नो, आई स्टैंड बाय व्हाट आई से। तो ये जो एक डिफरेंट व्यू पॉइंट्स एक भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अम्ब्रेला के नीचे से निकल कर आ रहे हैं, हाउ दे माइट वर्क फॉर बीजेपी चांसेस?
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी फुलिश स्टेटमेंट दैट समबडी इज मेकिंग। Look at how many, 3.2 million people have come from India to United States. We are part of this country. We have every possible right, whatever is available to anybody. Muslims who lived in India erstwhile before 1947, they were part of India. They are citizens of India. They have equal rights. They should not have more rights, but they have equal rights. And that's my position on that. And these kind of statements, they create nothing but violence, and they create unnecessary conflicts, and they derail the discussion totally to a, you know, kind of an area which doesn't benefit anybody. And they should stay away from that kind of a, you know, statement. So, they should respect the rights of everybody. Everybody is going to be a citizen, and people have difference of opinion. That's perfectly all right.
So that point well taken, they should stay away. But on the contrary, even when he's asked by president of his party, वो कहते हैं कि नहीं, मैंने तो कुछ गलत नहीं कहा है. तो इस तरह के ये जो वक्तव्य आते हैं वो कांग्रेस का या और लोगों का जो एप्रीहेंशन है भारतीय जनता पार्टी के बारे में कि अगर नरेंद्र मोदी प्रधानमंत्री बनते हैं तो माइनॉरिटीज़ के लिए ठीक नहीं होगा, वो और ज़्यादा उनको बल मिलता है. सो आनंद जी, हाउ दिस माइट प्ले आउट इन द इलेक्शन?
या दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड इन द वेरी बिगनिंग. आई एम वेरी सेक्युलर एंड आई बिलीव इन दोज काइंड ऑफ फिलॉसफीज, एंड आई फील वेरी मच हर्ट when I see that how religion is yoked to politics, and then how politicians, they exploit that. As far as I am concerned, I normally am reminded of an old Urdu couplet, ki mujhko to hai dono se hi vaasta, dairo haram aur butkhane se, mujhko to hai dono se hi vaasta, dairo haram aur butkhane se, ki main hindu hoon hinduon mein, और मुसलमान मुसलमानों में. तो फॉर मी इंडिया इज अ कंट्री विच इज फॉर एज डॉक्टर प्रवीण चोपड़ा सेड फॉर बोथ हिंदूज एज वेल एज फॉर मुस्लिम्स, एंड दिस काइंड ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स ऑनेस्टली स्पीकिंग कॉज मोर हार्म टू द leaders of the party, whether it's Rajnath Singh or Mr. Modi, and so, that's precisely that's one of the reasons I said that in the very beginning that either Arun Jaitley or Sushma Swaraj eventually will be a compromise candidate.
So to be fair to Narendra Modi, recently I heard his statements where he made it clear that he's addressing whole 125 crore Indians. So he has, in the recent statements that I heard, has always given a different version of their approach than what comes. But how opposition would be able to exploit it against BJP, what do you think?
My concern is, and I totally agree with both of them there, that these kind of statements that you quoted are totally unwarranted in 20th, 21st century. The world is a community right now. I mean, every Indian who is living here and has become prosperous and successful has done it without reservation, without any baggage that they brought from India. We are all together here independently. We had opportunity to do things, and we did it. The question here is, in my Twitter comment, I condemned Togari as a statement, and I said these kind of statements are totally unwarranted. But there's an important point here. Mr. Modi has not made these statements. On behalf of your party, somebody makes a stupid statement, you can't hold somebody else. That, what do you say about that? It is to be condemned. It doesn't require a mind of a genius to say so. Having said that, the opposition parties will exploit it, and Mr. Modi must distance himself from these kind of negative statements. The world is a community. As you said very correctly, India is a country for everybody, not only Hindus and Muslims, but Christians. Everybody prospers. It's a really a homogeneous society. If there is one country which is accepting, not tolerating, accepting freedom of religion, it's India. Because every religion, single religion, has prospered there. On the other hand, we are the only people, Hindus, who allow ourselves to be converted should an opportunity arise, either via coercion or by inducement.
So I think you leave at a point which requires a lot of discussion, which we do not have today, to get into the details, whether Hindus allow themselves to be converted or not, and what is the foundation of this conclusion. It is worth analyzing and discussing. Probably we'll do that some other day. But it has been great being with all of you, Dr. Praveen Chopra, Anand Ahuja ji, Rohan Chawla ji.
Finally, you got my name right.
Vibhuti Jha ji. So, and of course, being with all of you makes it meaningful and enriching for us. Thank you very much for joining us, and looking forward to meeting you tomorrow. This is the Show Quest.